What's going on, my mobile PD peeps? Thanks for watching this tutorial to learn about 6 editing cuts to improve your mobile videos using the PowerDirector Mobile Video Editor app. Editing cuts move the story along, shift perspective, and create a better viewing experience for your audience. Understanding the different cuts and what they do will help you create better mobile videos for your viewers. Let's cut some stuff up. The simplest cut is the standard cut. With the standard cut, you place two clips up against one another in a timeline and one clip plays after the other. What you want to do is move your playhead to a position after the first clip. Then go ahead and tap on the plus sign. Make sure that you're on the video tab. Go to the location on your device where the video is. Tap on the video you want to use and tap the plus sign. And now, you have the standard cut. Next is the jump cut. This is a version of the standard cut that uses the same clip to remove gaps or pauses when a person is speaking, just like this.
Bad audio equals bad video. Hey, PowerDirector peeps, how y'all doing out there? My name is Malik, and I'm back on your screen with more PowerDirector love from PowerDirectorUniversity.com. Today, I'm going to be doing a tutorial on the audio editor in PowerDirector 17.
So to create a jump cut, you want to move your playhead to the position right before you make a mistake or you pause. And you want to tap on the clip, and then you want to tap split. And then you want to move your playhead to after the pause or after the mistake, right where you want to go ahead and start speaking again. Then you want to tap split again. Then you want to tap on the middle section. This is where the pause happened or the mistake happened. And you want to go ahead and tap on delete. And then those two clips are right up against one another. And you got a beautiful jump cut. Now let's talk about cutting on action. Cutting on action is another form of the standard cut, but this cut is used to switch from one angle to another angle, continuing the action from the previous clip. So what you want to do is tap on the first clip, and you want to move your playhead forward to a position where you want to switch the angle. So I want to switch the angle like right when he's punching. And I'm going to go ahead and split this clip here. Then I'm going to go ahead and tap on delete to remove the middle clip. And I'm going to tap on the second clip, and I'm going to move my playhead to the position where I want the angle to switch. So, of course, I want him to be throwing a punch with his right hand just like he was in the first clip so that they match up. Then you want to go ahead and split your clip. You want to tap on the middle clip. You want to tap on delete. And when you play this back, you'll see it switch from one angle to another while continuing the same action of throwing that punch and bringing his hand back. Now, let's get into crosscuts. This technique is used to show different perspectives of the same event by switching between multiple clips. So I have a clip here of two people going on a date. It's a lovely evening.
Lovely evening.
And I also have several clips of food being prepared, as you can see if I scrub the timeline real quickly. By cross-cutting the clips, I can help drive the point that the food is being prepared as the couple waits. So what we want to start off by doing is placing the splits in the first clip where we want to inject the other clips. So you want to move your playhead to a position where you want to put your first clip in. Tap on this clip and tap split. And then you want to keep selecting your positions. And once you have all of your splits set up on that first clip, all you really have to do is drag your other clips in the position and trim them. So I'm going to place my finger over this first clip, hold it till I see that yellow bounding box. I'm going to drag it where the first split is. I'm going to let it go. Then I'm going to tap on this clip again, and I'm going to go ahead and place my finger at the end. Hold my finger down, and I'm going to trim this down to however many seconds I want it to be. Then I'll continue doing that with the other clips. And when you're done, You've got cross-cut McLovin. Cut number five is the J-cut. This cut involves using two clips that have audio and video. It makes the audio of the second clip come in prior to the video of the second clip. I have a clip of some ladies breaking down a river dance, followed by a clip of some people partying at a festival, getting their boogie on. So the first thing that I need to do is separate the audio from the video of the second clip. So I'm going to tap on the second clip, and I'm going to go ahead and tap on duplicate. And I'm going to go ahead and hold my finger over this first version of the clip, and I'm going to drag it down to the audio section. And now I have the clip, and then I have the audio of it separate. Next, I need to go ahead and move the clip that's on the media track to the overlay track. So I'm going to go ahead and tap on it, hold down my finger, and drag it down to the overlay track. Now that moves the second clip over, so I need to move it back, and I'm going to use a color board to move it back over. So I'm going to go ahead and tap on the media icon. I'm going to go to photo. I'm going to go to color board. And I'm going to choose a black color board. You can choose whichever one you want. I'm going to go ahead and tap on the plus sign. And it'll add it right before that first clip. And I'm going to tap back. And I'll tap back. Now I need to change the duration of the color board and drag it out to the position where I want the audio to come in. So I'm going to tap on the color board. I'm going to drag this over to where I want the audio to start. Then I'm going to tap on the audio. And I'm going to hold my finger over it until I get this yellow bounding box. And I'm going to drag it right over to where the clip on the media track is located. Now I need to go ahead and tap on the clip that's on the media icon. And I need to go ahead and tap on volume. And I need to mute this volume, because I don't want both of the volumes to be heard. Then I need to tap on the audio, and I need to go ahead and tap on volume, and I want to move the playhead over to the point where I want the audio to be heard, and I'm going to go ahead and tap on add keyframe. Then I'm going to move my playhead back to the beginning, and I'm going to drag the slider down to zero, which will make it fade in. Then I'm going to tap on the clip that's on the overlay track. I'm going to tap on volume again. I'm going to move the playhead to the position where I want the audio to start going down. I'm going to tap add a keyframe. I'm going to move my playhead to the end. And I'm going to drag the slider down to zero. Now you got yourself a magnificent J-cut. Last but not least, we have the L cut. It's the opposite of the J cut. The video shows up prior to the audio coming in. So we don't need this color board anymore. So I'm going to tap on that and we'll delete that. We're going to tap on the audio and we're going to drag it all the way to the beginning. And then we're going to go ahead and drag the overlay clip further down where you want it to begin. We'll tap on the audio volume. We'll tap on volume. We'll go back to the first keyframe that we created. And we'll remove that. Then we'll go to the end where we want the volume to start decreasing. We'll tap on add a keyframe. We'll go to the end. And we'll bring the slider down to zero. Then we're going to tap on the overlay icon. We'll tap on volume again. We'll go remove this last keyframe. We'll go to the position where we want the audio to come in and be fully on the screen. We'll tap on add a keyframe. We'll go to the beginning of the clip. And we'll move the slider down to zero. And now you have yourself a luxurious L cut. Cutalicious. PowerDirector has a wealth of editing tools for your eye holes. If you want more scrumptious editing tips, be sure to check out this video. Don't forget to smash my logo to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.